Okay, if 2019 elections will be a comedy with SmartMatic and maybe even Andy Bautista dahil hanggang ngayon nandiyan pa, napakakapal na mukha, ano? Kasi para to clear the way, sana umatras na siya at hindi ba mag leave of absence and so on. I do not understand sa basic decency, wala itong taong ito. But could it be because he is compromised and the powers that be need him there? Ano? Na maituloy yung programa, kung ano man programa nila para sa bayan na to na masaklap sa taong bayan. And we're so happy si Attorney Mel Magdamo arrived already from Candelaria, Quezon. Ano? And of course, he is the famed COMELEC whistleblower. Let me see. I think we have an image, you know, a report on yon, many things that he has exposed in the COMELEC. COMELEC illegally printed millions of ballots, whistleblower claims. So that is Attorney Mel Magdamo. So let's go back to Mel. So Mel, as we had the background of Attorney Al a while ago, you also exposed initially the overpriced envelopes, yes, ng COMELEC. Ano? Okay, let's flash back for a minute lang, 30 seconds. Bakit mo ginawa yon? Ano ba yung overpriced? How overpriced was it?
By unit, each folder cost 3 pesos and 80 centavos. The decimal point jumped 2 digits to the right. So each folder became 380 pesos.
From 3 pesos, naging 300 pesos.
Oh. The total is 700 million pesos.
Okay. And then, ano ba itong isa na lumabas later on? Yung, the one I showed? Yung, ano ba yan? Extra ballots printed.
Extra ballots. Printed after election of 2013.
Ah, bakit nga ba?
After election?
After. Eh? Oh, normally, no. One ballot, one voter is only one ballot, normally. So now, they printed 11 million excess.
This is for the 2016 election?
2013 election.
Pero after election na, sabi mo.
So
kumita lang yon, para kumita lang.
Para kumita, and it's possible that that same overprinted ballots in 2013 were used in
2016.
It's possible. Ayun, it's very possible.
So, big question mark. Ano? Anomalous question mark. Okay, so now, we're confronted with this problem of the comedy, if not the crisis, in 2019 elections with SmartMatic still there, which Attorney Alvitangcol says is bound to happen unless something dramatic intervenes. Ano? Mm-hmm. So, our question now is, what do we do? What is to be done? The legislators medyo up this time, parang matabang pa, mm-hmm, na gumawa ng dramatic action to investigate Bautista. Meron bang investigation, Al?
There are proposals to investigate him, no? Pero there are no concrete details as of now. No?
At saka
unlike
back,
the impeachment of Chief Justice Sereno, it's now moving.
Moving, okay.
So there is, I think, also an impeachment case to be filed against Bautista, pero wala pang endorser.
Okay. And before I go to my point, I'll go to Mel. Anong maidadagdag mo doon sa nabanggit ni Attorney Al?
There will be also vacancies
sa
commissioners.
Okay.
So this is the chance of President Duterte to, if he's really serious, he will be having three appointees.
I'm surprised to hear that. You're a very avid Duterte supporter, pero you can still say that if he is really serious in cleaning up the COMELEC. Okay, why? You have doubts?
In 2010, then President Noynoy Aquino said he is serious in cleaning COMELEC.
Uh-huh.
And look what he did. So usually whoever gets into power, they want a system that's in favor in themselves.
Well, that's why I'm saying, short of revolution, baka hindi na pwedeng hindi revolutionary government. President Digong might as well declare a revolutionary government, no election for a year or two until everything is reformed, ano, and put on track. Would you call for a revolution na para masolve itong SmartMatic Andy Bautista problem? Or is that burning down the house to kill the fly or the mouse?
I believe there's a way of a constitutional democratic revolutionary government. There's a way for doing that.
Parang nakikinig kay Bono Adasa.
Ano, I'm not using the methods of Bono.
Ah, sige,
but
sige.
Another method.
Paliwanag mo yung... So you already accept the revolution ang kailangan?
Yes, I accept.
Ah, okay. anong reaction ng isang abogado natin?
I do.
Mukhang tapos na ang debate dito sa discussion natin. Okay. Anyway, so, short of the revolution, meron pa na paraan. Mukhang wala.
I cannot think of anything.
I think that there is another way, no?
Oh, sige, please.
In fact, under the Constitution, except for the heads of the agencies, the president can remove any member of the constitutional body.
Ah, okay.
Except for the head.
Mm.
It's embodied in, I think, Article 9 of the Constitution. Mm-hmm. So, the president can just say that, okay, all the commissioners of the COMELEC, except the head, no?
The head is Andy Bautista right now.
Yeah, will be replaced.
Uh-huh.
And then the head will be impeached.
Ah, okay.
So it's one way of doing
that. When the head is in the process of impeachment, is he immobilized? Does somebody have to be appointed to replace him?
Hindi
naman. But at least that will put pressure on him and his behavior, di ba?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
So meron naman paraan. You have actually proposed one. That replacement of the two COMELEC commissioners, kung maayos, baka malaking tulong yun sa pag-aayos ng eleksyon sa 2019. Right?
The replacement of two commissioners plus the chairman, the head. Plus the head.
So kailangan talaga.
Okay.
But the chairman that enjoys tenure, but you say he can remove the chairman? No.
No. It's only through impeachment.
But the chairman is elected by the NBank?
No.
Hindi. Ng presidente talaga. From the past president. Oh, well, that's really a dilemma. But if you can change all the other four commissioners except the head, four commissioners ba? Five yan, no?
Yeah, seven.
Seven. If you can change the other six, immobilize na yung, yung head.
Mm-hmm.
And can they nullify the contracts with Smartmatic?
Yes, they could. Because everything is decided and bound.
So mayroon, pwede pa namang one step to revolution. Pwede pa pala. Okay. So, Mr. President, I hope you're listening to this discussion. So, if in case that can happen, now we go to the main question ko sa inyo. Should we go back to manual plus electronic transmission? Kasi yun na ang proposal that can be done with local technology quickly. Before the ballots are printed for the 2019, we have 2018 to work on this legally in terms of the law. And I understand from previous discussions, 5 years of discussions, the law itself allows the variations of technology and systems, di ba? From Mel muna. Mel,
At least 18 first world countries around the world uses that method of secret voting and public counting, which means manual in the prisons and electronic transmission.
Well, we have a shot later of the list of some countries, no, which the public will be surprised about. Al, what do you think?
Actually, it's allowed by the law, no?
To shift away
from automated election system law uses the word may.
May.
It says it may use. But it does not say it shall use.
So it may use system. Automated system. Yes. It may use automated and such systems.
So that means it's permissive, not mandatory.
So, Mr. President, you hear from our two law experts, professionals, that the door is open for you to decide on how we can set aright the 2019 elections. Okay. So, let's look at some of these. Of course, let's review yung record ng Smartmatic in the past year. And this is the Venezuela situation. In Venezuela, there was an election and Maduro's candidates won for the Constituent Assembly, I think whatever they call that assembly. And after some time, did Smartmatic, when the Americans were already launching its destabilization against Maduro, Smartmatic comes out to say that there was manipulation with their system. Please, Al, you seem to be more familiar than me on that. Please explain it. Yeah.
Okay. Smartmatic's admission that the election results were manipulated is a tacit admission on the part that their system is not secured.
That's right, yeah.
So, how come somebody else could manipulate it?
Yeah.
That's the first question. Second, if they insist that their system is secured, then the follow-up question is, who manipulated it? Mm. Then it will be Smartmatic themselves.
Mm.
So if that is the case, then they do not have the credibility to hold the election.
Yeah. So the Smartmatic was used in Venezuela and has been used in Venezuela for many, many years already. But now, is it because the chairman of Smartmatic or the company that owns Smartmatic, Lord Mark Malok Brown, received orders from higher ups, ano, because of the campaign to destabilize Maduro? What's your opinion, Mel?
Yes, because in the Philippines, if in baseball there is a strike three rule, mm-hmm. in Philippines, Smartmatic is already strike four. We have forgotten in 2008.
Hindi ba strike 400 na? Sige, sige, 2008. No.
That was in the autonomous region in Muslim Mindanao.
Yeah, yeah.
Smartmatic had a big, big error there. Mm. They only reached 30%, 38% accuracy. And the balances are erroneous, no? So that alone should have disqualified Smartmatic for 2010. But Smartmatic became the provider in 2010, in 2013, and even in 2016.
Mm. Okay, a while ago, while we were off the air, I think Mel said that we were on the air already. 16 countries have rejected automation and use manual plus some electronic transmission. No? Okay, here are some reports. From Europe first, please look at this image. Europe rejects digital voting machine. Anyway, of course, you can't read the body of the item, no? But the headline says it all. And now we go to the next image. Electronic voting machines, EVMs, fraud controversy. List of countries that have banned electronic voting. Let me see. Apparently, we cannot focus on the details now. So I will read the countries that have banned these machines. I have it here. Let me just... okay. Daming materials dito. These countries are... this is by Krishnan. No? Aishwarya Krishnan. A report, and these are the countries, there are only six here, but these are very significant countries. Germany has rejected automated election and back to manual since 2008, if I recall correctly. Netherlands, ano? Ireland, England, France, and Italy. Ano? What the countries can you add to that since you know 16?
There's Australia, and there are various countries, Scandinavian countries, and there's also parts of India.
Yeah, okay.
Locally.
Yeah, you were praising the Indian system. Please go ahead, Al.
Actually, one good model is the Indian election system. Because in India, they do not mandate, no, that each particular region would follow a certain configuration.
Mm.
So it seems that the system in itself is fitted into the requirements of a certain region.
Okay.
Unlike in the Philippines,
mas flexible sila.
It's rigid, no? Let's say kung picos tayo, picos lahat.
Mm.
So ito, it varies. And I think that is better, no?
Yes.
For example, in the provinces, no, na talagang let's say hindi ito talagang advanced na province, no? So pwedeng wala ding kuryente. Let's say mga dinagat islands, no?
Mm.
So, do not force them to use the PICOS machine, di ba?
Yeah.
So, po pwedeng dyan, manual.
Mm.
And then, po pwedeng ballot boxes, no? Not really electronic boxes.
That's right, yeah.
So, it should depend, no?
Tapos, pag na-confirm na sa counting doon sa, ng tao mismo sa presinto, i-transmit na by electronic para mabilis. Hindi na mananakaw ang ballot boxes and so on kasi nandoon na sa head office ng COMELEC or the election body. Well, we've run out of time. 30 seconds each, Mel, and then Al, please.
I fully agree with that regionalizing and customizing the system to the region. Because, for example, the ballot itself, it's paper. In the Philippines, it's very humid.
Mm.
When humidity enters the paper, it's very difficult to force fit into the
machine. Ah, okay. So, Al, yeah.
Basically, what should we be doing so that we could have a impartial and credible elections in 2019. Number one, we should be vigilant, ano? Let's look at the way COMELEC is doing its bidding process, and we should ensure that Smartmatic will not win any contract anymore. Mm.
Okay, and the other practical steps we advise the president is platoon substitution of the COMELEC chairman of the COMELEC commissioners para ma-corner si Chairman Bautista. And maybe remove Chairman Bautista, complete revamp, back to manual plus electronic transmission. Ano? So there are practical solutions without declaring a revolutionary government yet. Ano? Okay, maraming salamat. We've run out of time. And we'll continue to pursue these issues in our future episodes. And have a good weekend.